passing accuracy 91%. They have 96%. Jesus Christ. We have met our passing opponents. I mean, they are freaking off the Richter scale with their passing. That's phenomenal accuracy. That means we definitely can't be wasteful with possession. Oh, that's a bit of a speculative shot. We've got to be so good in possession. We can't afford any sloppy passes. Really got to man up. Really got to man up. Come on. We've got to man up. It's time to turn on the Barca of East London style. Just knock the ball around. Wait for them to make the error. Wait for them to come to us. Oh, Gabby Dini. Oh, I could have gone to his left foot, John. Thinking way too far ahead, you idiot. But after this, though, we still have got the England episodes to come, which should be good fun. I'm trying to draw them out. I want them to make the error. I don't want to make the error. But I do know if I lose the ball, I'm going to get absolutely... Look at the two strikers sitting up there, little bastards. This is it. Oh, Felipe, I pulled the trigger. Great defensive tackle. But I've lost the ball, which I really didn't want to be doing. Get across. Just, that's it, stand him up. No need to commit. No need to make silly... Oh, do you know, I drew the wrong defender there. Made a silly error. It's all they need. Look at that passing of freaking Juventus. I'm glad I didn't... In the back of my mind, I really want to play this game on Legendary. But I'm glad I didn't. Not with their passing ability. Their passing of 96% on world class is phenomenal. So good with possession. But we do have England episodes to come after this. We'll be able to win the World Cup. I just hope we don't end potless in the West Ham season. Oh... Hopefully, the idea is to get to the major parts of the competition, such as like the quarterfinal onwards will be live episodes, so like the group stages will be edited, and then we'll get into season 7, bang out season 7 in record time, absolute record time, finish off Newcastle, see how we're fixed for time, Butland with a huge save. And then, FIFA 14, the fun starts all over again. But with FIFA 14, I'm looking forward to using FIFA 14. Oh, that's great. Come on, Stasic. That's it. Get forward, son. Knock it into Olajuwon. Okay, don't knock it into Olajuwon. Oh, don't lose the ball. Oh, John. Oh, my days. That would have been a... Do you know what? Opportunity opens. Opportunity knocks. Oh, the deflection. Well, getting Marquisio off the pitch is a good start. 72nd minute of the game, 0-0. Hasn't been spectacular, but it may not have been the best game for you guys to watch, but I do apologise, but honestly, I really don't care because I want this bloody trophy. If I have to play the most negative football in the world, we will, and if that gives us a trophy, a title, so bloody be it, because we need to finish with silverware. We need to finish with silverware. We definitely need to... Whoa, sugar. Was that a shot? That definitely weren't a cross. Good God, that was a bit speculative. Come on, we've got time. Might have to make some substitutions. At this moment in time, I'm happy with the way the team's playing. They had 6 days off, so they should be okay, fitness-wise. It's been a hard game, but we haven't been doing the running. At the end of the day, it's been Juventus who have really done a lot of the running because we've had so much possession. Around the corner. First time. Oh, Gabbiadini, this is it! Yes! Come on! 80th minute! Get in there! Normally roll it around and put it onto his right foot. Went back across him. Oh, that first touch done the defender. The centre back has no agility. Get in there, boys! 80th minute. Finish the season on a bloody high. Come on. Now we need to get hold of the ball to be able to keep the ball. Don't overrush my defending. Stay steady. That's all we've got to do. Oh, shit. Oh, thank God for that. What a woeful header. I want to knock the ball on, but I think that's like giving away possession, so I'm going to knock it short. Has cost me many, many previous episodes knocking it short at critical times of the game. They're really not up in their game. Juventus aren't really coming for me. I'm quite surprised. Oh, knock the ball through. Oh, the wrong player was running. Olajuwon. Oh my God, John, you tit. Keep possession. Don't gift it back to him so easily. Juventus are more intent on keeping the ball. Do they not realise it's 1-0? Oh, I said this against Bayern Munich, but they were playing sweaty football and they scored against me. So I'm going to keep my mouth shut, realistically. Getting that. Oh, Kyle. Shit. Come on. Lamella, do a job. Play. No, not a corner. Ah, no. Corner. Come on. Their goalkeeper's up. No. Do not do this to me. What an opportunity. Holy shit. Wow. That was a huge miss. That's it. Sit him away. The whistle's gone. Yes. Get in there. So chuffed for the lads. So bloody proud of the lads. Oh, that is exceptional. I swear I gotta be.
To love it, I'm on the way to the summit, and all the haters are waiting to see the day that I plummet. They better stay in their place because the paper is coming, and when I make it, their bank is getting the payment of nothing. Now I'm destined to make it big. I think by now I made that evident, but I'm grinding till they know Calvin Coolidge is the rapper and not the president. See, I don't want to live an average life, drive an average car, fucking average wife, have a couple of kids. These are average sights and the average life of the average white. And now all these kids are being
safe to say. It does not get any better than that. It really, really doesn't. So chuffed. Finished the season with silverware. We played them off the park, possession-wise. Well, saying that, no. Second half, we had 57% in that first half. They really did bring it back. 8 shots, 3 on target. We had 6 with 4 on target. Passing accuracy, we dropped from 91 to 90. They dropped from 96 to 93. That is unbelievable bloody pass accuracy. Their shooting accuracy was pretty damn lame. That... Oh, I'm so chuffed. We just bloody won the Champions Cup. That's our second Champions Cup. That is just amazing. I'm so happy. That's made this season a very hard season. Absolutely worth it. Absolutely worth it. So overjoyed. Oh, how much money? 6.3 million. No, that's not too bad. I'm happy with that. It will do. I'm not really fussed about the money. Wow. No love for Gabbiadini at Juventus. 1-0. Gabbiadini with the goal. That really has made... Oh, what a season. Full of highs and lows. Scored a lot of goals. Boss, I can't lie. I was worried that you had plans to replace me. Filippo, my son. Do not ever think that. I now know it was all media speculation that gave me a case of paranoia. Thanks for being patient and letting me know that this isn't the case. Come on, Filippo. We've been through thick and thin, lad. I'm going to have to send you a text message. I will do that obviously after recording this. I'll send him a text message. We'll probably go out for a few bevvies tonight. Understandably, after winning the Champions Cup, the boys are going to get lagered up. So chuffed. Absolutely so bloody chuffed. Players' contracts expiring. Okay, so Carlos Tevez and... Ah, there we go. Look at Filippo. 150G a week. 5 years, 2 months he's signed on for. We have 49 mil. Oh, I wonder if we're going to. I wonder what our transfer budget will be. Hopefully, we'll be approaching the 60 million mark. Be really, really nice. We can make some really good changes. Obviously, let's just change this around. So, Tevez, he has 2 months. He's refused a contract. And we have Tremel, who. He's not really going to. The Tremel brother, the first Tremel brother, isn't he? He wants a 4-year deal on 2,500. We're only going to loan him out. He's worth, what, 300 grand. It's just not worth the hassle. Tevez, on the other hand, he wants 60 for a year. Mm-hmm. If he accepts it, he accepts it. I might look to shift him. Might try and shift him in a deal or something. We'll just have to wait and see. We'll have to wait and see what you guys think, what we need to do from the squad-wise. I would like to bring in a couple of English players. I really, really would. That could mean sacrificing a couple of strikers, bringing in an English lad. Or I don't know where we're going to bring an English lad in. We'll just have to try and figure it out. None of them are at the appropriate age, but they're all looking pretty good. I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing Alessandro. Who else? Where is he? Yes, Stuart Perk. I'm looking forward to seeing how he develops. He's looking pretty good. Oh my God! What a season! What a bloody season! I'm glad you're back, lad. Okay, that's fine. That is fine. Says transfer window's open. I think he's up for sale anyway, so hopefully we'll get someone come in. I can't understand why he's actually saying that. I really can't. Let's look at the squad. You look at the amount of games that he's played compared to everybody else. I mean, yeah, okay, Butland's paid 50, 43, 34, 50 for Colker, 26. I mean, we have asked a huge amount of this man. Absolutely a huge amount. You mean you look at the game, he's played 45 games. He's missed 5 games throughout the entire season. 5 games. Really, really isn't a huge amount at all. I'm shocked at the way he's... then again, that's media speculation for you. That's what the media can do to you. It can send you a little bit loopy-woopy. And it sent him loopy-woopy. No, I'm not renewing the contracts. I'm not fast. It's just advance, and get rid of that table on the right-hand side, because that's just horrifically horrible. Not impressed with that at all. Really, really not impressed with that. Second in the Barclays Premier League. Very, very disappointing. What have you got for us? Have a quick look through these. 81, 87, 75... Nothing too good, so we'll just keep looking at the lads, see if they can develop. Oh God, no! Come on, keep looking at the lad. And a final report. Oh no, 77 not good enough. Very interesting. Right, we'll just have to let that rest. Advance further forward. Come on. Get the days of flying. Get the days flying. I hate it when it slows down. It should, I mean, at the end of the day, nothing's really happening in this section of the career. It should fly through. Morning, boss. I've got some good news to share. I've come to the realisation that I'm pretty happy here, so I'd like to stay and play for the club. Right, so you want to... Oh, so he does want to stay. He's got 1 month left on his contract. I'm going to give him a 1-year deal. 1-year deal. No signing on fee. No nothing. 1-year deal. Not going to cost us anything because we're already paying him that. So that's fine. Quickly advance. Nothing's going to happen. It looks like we're going to go into the exciting section. And hopefully he'll sign his bloody contract. I didn't actually put you. Oh, okay. I put you in this. Yeah, I put you on a substitutes bench. So I didn't actually do anything with you. Bit surprised about that. It's a little bit weird. Player's contract's expired. I've offered him a new contract. Jesus Christ, what's going on? We have entered the World Championship. This is it. Let's have a look at our group. Can we see our group? Season stats, World Champs, group tables. Let's have a look at our group table. Oh, that's not a nice group. The Russia game is definitely going to be a very, very tough game. Not looking forward to that by any stretch of the imagination. Not too sure about the Chile game. Alexis Sanchez will probably be early, mid-30s. Six seasons, he's what, 26? So 4 years, 30, 32-ish, 33-ish. So that should be interesting. Bulgaria, not 100% sure about Bulgaria. I mean, Berbatov will be, what, 57? 67, something like that. So he won't be playing. He's 33, so he'll be, what, Christ, nearly 40. 39, 40. So hopefully he won't be playing. He won't be in the team. But, yeah, that's an interesting group. That's going to be a tough group. Let's have a look and see the other groups. Group B, Germany, Turkey, Mexico, Uruguay. Be interesting to put in the comment section below who you think is going to qualify out of each group. Obviously, out of our group, it's going to be us. I'm going to call the group winners. I'm going to say England in Group A, Group B, Germany. Very tough group, though. Very tough group. Group C, France, Austria, Australia, and Colombia. Well, I've got quite a few Australian subscribers, so I'm going to call Australia for Group C. We don't really want to see the French or the Austrians come through there, or the Colombians. We want to see Australia come through. That'd be nice for Australia. Wow, Group D, Argentina, Portugal, Switzerland, and New Zealand. Well, I do have a Portuguese subscriber. Well, I think he's Portuguese. He supports Benfica, so I presume he would be Portuguese. So I'm going to call Portugal. Obviously, that's Cristiano Ronaldo. Hopefully, we won't meet them until the final. If we get to the final, fingers crossed, touch wood. Spain, Finland, Northern Ireland, and Cote d'Ivoire. Why don't I just put the Ivory Coast? It's so much easier. Got to be going with Spain. Would be nice to see an underdog like Finland or Northern Ireland come through, but I think, yeah, Spain in Group E. Wow, Group F. Well, obviously, we've got to go for Italy because that's where our talisman, Filippo, plays. So, Italy in Group F for me personally. Yeah, that's still a tough group, though. Very tough group. I wouldn't want to be playing in there. Group G, Egypt, Korea, Hungary, and the Netherlands. Well, obviously, we have a stake in the Netherlands with Bruno Martin Indies playing in there. So, I would like to think that the Netherlands would come through that one. I think that'd be probably the easiest group. I was going to say the toughest group, but Korea, Republic, Egypt, and Hungary. I think Netherlands should breeze past those with consummate ease. Group H, South Africa, Scotland, Sweden, and Brazil. Well, let's be honest, Brazil or Brazil. Hopefully, they don't have too many exciting players. But you've got to go and think Brazil all the way there, unfortunately. It would be nice to see Scotland come through, but I don't think they will, unfortunately. I'm going to call Brazil as the group winners. And back to us. That's quite an interesting one. That's wow. Oh, intriguing. But just in case, I'll show you the squad. Just in case you haven't seen the squad, I will show you the squad. We are playing obviously the 4-2-3-1. This is the squad that we have. So we have Butland, Klein, Phil Jones, Colker, Gibbs, Wilshere, Rodwell, Morrison, Cleverley, Oxlade, Chamberlain, Wayne Rooney, Walker, Russell, McEachran, Smalling, I need a drink, my mouth is going so dry, Carroll, Hart, Sinclair, Robinson, Welbeck, Sturridge, Fraser Foster, Theo Walcott. That is quite a nice side. I don't think that's going to be the first team I'm going to use. I want to use Danny Welbeck up front. Actually, I might use Sturridge. Might use Sturridge. I got Oxlade. Ravel Morrison. I might use Sturridge there. I'm thinking about Sturridge. Because he can cut in on that left foot. He's got a nice left foot. I definitely want Kyle Walker at right back. I put Colker next to him. Phil Jones, Gibbs. Wilshere, definitely. I might put Morrison in the centre of park next to him. Who else have we got? Let's have a look at their levels. Morrison's an 82. Oh, I'm used to playing with Morrison, so I'm going to put Morrison in there. I'm not a great fan of Rodwell. Obviously, I'm going to put you on the bench. How old is he now? 32. Carroll, 20. Ooh. Good little young player. Get some use out of him. I haven't got space for Theo at the moment. I'll put Theo on the bench. I don't want to use too many of my superstars, but I'll put him on the bench. And yeah, that'll be the starting lineup. I think that's a pretty good, solid England side, to be honest. Definitely think that's a solid England side. I'm happy with that. Hopefully we will do well in our first game. It's against Bulgaria. As I say, I think the biggest game in the group is going to be against Russia. But we have to do the business against Bulgaria, so don't want to be counting my chickens, etc. Anyway, that is this episode done and dusted. The season is officially finished. We've now got to do the England episodes. England episodes, as I say, will be edited up until the quarter, semis and final. If we can get to those, they'll be magnificent. They will be live. They will be live and just looking at... They didn't take... Oh, I'm surprised at that. So they went with, I suppose, Mario Balotelli and... Stefan El Shaarawy is quite phenomenal. But, you know, do you know what? I mean, Gabbiadini scoring a winning goal in the Champions Cup and Destro playing really well. I mean, they scored goals this season. I'm surprised they haven't gone with them. Marco Verratti, I'd love to have Verratti. Freaking amazing player. Absolutely amazing player. Really strong squad there, the Italians have. And I've got to say, a strong squad. Damn. Anyway, that's enough. We won the Champions Cup. I hope you celebrated, because I bloody did. And I'm going to go and have a well-deserved beer to celebrate success in Season 6. Roll on bloody Season 7, because I want to bash that out like a motherfucker before FIFA 14, which gives me day of recording. This will blow your mind. It's the 7th of September, so it will give me 20 days, which is going to be a lot of hard freaking work. But do you know what? I'm up for it, as long as you guys are up for it. If you want Season 7, post a comment in the section below, or we can end it at Season 7 and then concentrate on starting perhaps in Week 2 of FIFA 14, something like that. Entirely up to you guys. I do know what I'm going to start with in FIFA 14, but I'm not going to reveal it just yet. I'm not going to reveal it just yet, because I've already given away my career mode idea, so... I don't want to give away too much else. It's going to be interesting to see how many people do West Ham in FIFA 14. It's going to be interesting to see how many people do add in the youth squad, how many people do the transfer reviews, because transfer reviews are going to be back. Oh, yes, every season they're going to be back. We're also going to be doing the youth squad player reviews. They're going to be back. They're going to be more regular as well as the youth squad updates. On top of that, the Daily Jaffa is going to be pumped out. Some episodes it'll just be the front page, some episodes it'll be both, some episodes it'll just be the back page, etc. And all the stories will be moulded around you guys. You're going to have to connect with the story that we have and make it grow and etc. You know the score at the end of the day. So it's going to be really exciting. That's really going to be good fun. Looking forward to that. Obviously, we're going to bring in a man of the match system. Now, I do know Master Bucks does a man of the match system. Ours is going to be completely different because obviously the last thing I need is people saying, oh, you're copying. I've sort of done something in Newcastle, but not. I don't want to touch anything that he's sort of done, essentially, so we can have our own player of the year, etc. Hopefully it will stat track the whole process. If it doesn't, we're going to be stat tracking it, or I'm going to be stat tracking it, so we can reel off statistics of how many games. For example... who's going to be one of my favourite players in the West Ham team? Obviously, Mark Noble and Mohamed Adeyemi are going to be a couple of my favourite players. Nolan, it'd be nice to see Adeyemi go 6 seasons again and be able to turn around to you guys and say Adeyemi played 332 games, scored 17 goals and was booked 10 times and sent off. Never, because he's just biblical. But that's a random statistic. I don't know where I got that from, but there we go. Anyway, that's just a little bit of an insight of what's coming. Ooh, what a freaking season. I'm going to go and have a beer. I hope you have enjoyed Season 6 thus far. We will be finishing it off with England. So let's all get behind England. I know some of my subscribers are not English, and perhaps some of your nations are playing in my group or in a few groups. But please give your support. It'll mean the world to me personally, because it's been a hard season. It's been a very long year on FIFA 13, And hopefully things will grow and get better and it'll be enjoyable in FIFA 14. Anyway, guys, I'm rambling. Until next time, I will catch you later.